press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello children, how are you? I hope that all are doing good. So today I am going to deal a lesson. The name of the lesson is The Combat. So this combat, this lesson, it contains of two parts, that is combat first and combat second, is it? So today I am going to deal with the combat first. So this lesson, means this story, was written by Jayant Narlikar. Okay, so let's see about the writer's introduction. So who is he? So let's see here. So Jayant Narlikar, he is an Indian astrophysicist and also professor at the Inter University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics. Okay, so that is here IUCAA. So it means Inter University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics. Okay, so he was working in this institute. Okay, it is in the Institute of Astronomy, and he is a professor too. Okay, and he was born on 19th July 1938 in Kolhapur. Then, and here is the works. There are some of the works of Jayant Narlikar, that is The Scientific Edge, The Return of Vaman, The Lighter Side of Gravity. So these are the books which was written by Jayant Narlikar based on the physics, based on the research, whatever he has done, because he is a professor, he is working in the professor, and he has invented so many things which is related to the astronomy, and he is an astrophysics. Okay, so this is about the writer's introduction. So let's see about the comet. You know that you all love to see the comet, is it? So comet, here it looks like. So how it is? So you know that this comet, it contains of icy particles, and it has some gases, okay, and then it has some dusts, okay. So then when it passes throughout the sun, so when the light is reflect on this comet, so it becomes very shiny one, okay. So that's why it is look like a comet. So actually, what is this? What is this comet is? So I'm giving a little introduction about what is this comet. So here, a comet is an icy particles of solar system. Okay, so it is a icy particles of solar system. Then body that when passing close to the sun. Okay, so when it is passing towards the sun, so its body, it is actually, it is contains of icy particles. I told you it contains of gases, it contains of dust particles, and also it called as icy particles, which contains. So when it passes through the sun, okay, close to the sun, warms and begins to release gases. So when it is passes close to the sun, because of the warmness, because of the temperature, so when it is passes near to the sun, so because of that, and it the gases, it gets melt and it becomes shiny one. Okay, shiny, and begins to release gases, process called outgassing. So that process is called as a outgassing. Okay, so this is called as a comet. Sometimes it also has the tail. So when it moves, okay, so when it passes close to the sun, when it moves, and how it looks like there is a tail. Okay, so there is a tail. Sometimes it looks like this. So this is about a comet. So let's see about in this lesson. So what this lesson it contains. Okay, so let's see here. This lesson is going to be an interesting, because you know that we all love comet to see, and we all love to discover comet and stars and galaxies, is it? So why not we are not interested? Yes, of course, and you people, and even me also. So let's see here, what is this comet, this lesson is, and what it tells about. So let's see here. Before we are going to understand lesson, and we just going to read the lesson, let's see the background of this story. A new comet has appeared in the sky and is heading straight for the Earth. Okay, so a new comet which is appeared near the Earth, okay, which is in the sky and which is head straight for the Earth. So it is coming nearer to the Earth. A head on collision. So that head, it is on collision. Collision means crash, which is nearly unavoidable. So that collision should be unavoidable. It should not touch to the Earth. So that should be avoided. Okay, well, mean the end of life on this planet. If it going to be crashed, it going to be hit to the earth, it means that the earth, the life on the earth, it is going to be an end. So scientists and religious leaders react to this situation in different ways. What happens to this, to the comet? Okay. So here in this lesson, what we come to know about is this comet is going to be hit to the earth. Okay. So it going to be collide to the earth. So means crash. So when it going to be crashed to the earth, so what happened? So the whole earth is going to be spoiled, destroyed. Okay, so is it, you know, when they have discovered, means the scientists have discovered that, so this is going to happen in the future. So the scientists and even the religious preachers, so those people were thinking things in a different manners. Okay, though people, means these two groups, they will think in a different manner. So is it, it is going to be crashed to the earth? It should be avoidable. Okay, so the collision of the earth, it should be avoidable. Okay. So who is going to be avoided? So let's see here. If it going to be crash, it going to be collide to the earth. So the whole life on the earth, it is going to be destroyed. It is going to be an end of the earth. Okay. So let's see what happened in this lesson. Dattada, an amateur scientist, can't stay away from the keen-eyed Dibya Jakshu for long. Dibya helps him achieve his secret ambition. Dattada's wife Indrani Devi wishes he hadn't found the object of his search. Here there are three characters. Okay, which are the three characters? Let's see here. That is Dattada. The character in this lesson is That is Dattada. Then Dibya. It is a Dibya. Dibya. Then Indrani Devi. Okay, so these are the important characters in this story. So what happened here? So Dattada is an amateur scientist. So this Dattada, he is a scientist in this lecture, in this lesson. Amateur means a person attached to a pursuit without pursuing it professionally. So he is a scientist, but he is not a scientist. Actually, it is one of his hobby. Okay, so that's why he become a scientist, but not by professionally. So this is, and can't stay away from the keen eye Dibya Jakshu for long. So this Dattada, he is not stay away from this Dibya. Okay, so what is this Dibya? It is a keen eyed Dibya Jakshu. So let's see what is that Dibya. So Dibya is nothing. Here it is, it means it's a telescope. Okay, so he can't stay away from this telescope. Who? This Dattada. Okay, so Dattada, he is not he not keep that telescope away from him. Okay, so always he just carry and he just love to hold the telescope, and he just wanted to look at the sky. Okay, because he wanted to discover something about the comet. So this is his hobby, and also this one of the hobby makes him a worldwide known. Okay, so let's see what he has done here. Then Dattada's wife Dibya helps him achieve his secret ambition. So this Dibya, it is helping him to whom? To Dattada, to achieve his secret ambition. Whose secret ambition? That is Dattada's secret ambition, because he is a scientist. Okay, he had some ambition. As a scientist, he had some ambition. So this Dibya, it is helping to Dattada to achieve in his ambition. Okay, Dattada's wife Indrani Devi wishes he hadn't found the object of his search. So this Indrani Devi, so let's see here, who is this Indrani Devi? It's not a Devi, it's a Devi. Okay, it's a Devi. So she is the wife of Dattada. She is a wife of Dattada. Here she is wishing that, what she is wishing here, that he hadn't found the object of his search. So he is wishing that this Dattada, he could not find that object what he wanted, what he is searching for. So who is wishing here? Indrani Devi. So Indrani Devi, as a wife of Dattada, she is wishing that he should not found that object what he is searching, what he is looking for. Okay, so this is, let's see that in this lesson. It was a moonless night in December. It was a moonless night in December. A burst of cool breeze from the window was enough to disturb the sleep of Indrani Devi. So one night, it was a moonless night in the December month. In the month of December, there is no moon in the sky. Okay. Then a burst of cool breeze from the window was enough to disturb the sleep of Indrani Devi. It's a breezing. It's a winter time, so it's a cool breeze. So that's why it is disturbing. So that breeze is disturbing to Indrani Devi. So she can't sleep because of that breezing, cool breeze. Half awake, she felt for the adjoining pillow. All she knew the answer, that Dada was not there. Okay, half awake. In the middle of the night, she was wake up and she was looking that there is a pillow. Okay, on the bed there is a pillow and it was in an adjoining place. Okay, so that means she was finding her husband. Okay, so although she knew that answer, Dattada was not there. She is searching her husband, but he was not there. Okay, he was not there. He was went away from that room. So he has gone to hobnob with that wretched Dibya. Okay, so now she is thinking, now she understood that where is this Dattada. Okay, so now she is telling by herself that he has gone to hobnob. Hobnob means it's a friendly talk, spend time together. Means this Dattada, he is having a friendly time with the Dibya. So who is saying this? Indrani Devi is saying to her husband, okay, that they both are having a friendly talk. Okay, they all spend time together. Okay, so here Indrani Devi, she is not describing this is a telescope here. Okay, it is like it is a living thing. Okay, there is a life in this Dibya. So like that she is pursuing us. Okay, she is telling us. Then with that wretched Dibya, wretched means unhappy Dibya, at least he might have bothered to close the door. Because when Dattada was went away from the room, he forgot to close that door. Because from the door, so it was cool breeze. It is disturbing to Indrani Devi. So that's why. And then she was telling herself, so why not he has closed the door? Even as she muttered her complaints, Indrani Devi could not repress her smile. She is complaining about her husband, that while she was going out from the room, at least she could have to close the door, no? So he just went away. She was muttered. Muttered means in a low voice, she is telling herself, okay? And then Dibya could not repress her smile to keep back her smile. She knew how utterly oblivious her husband was of the practical problems of the living. She knew it that how her husband is having some problem of life, means he is having some health issues. And because of this thing, he has forgotten. Who? This Dattada has forgotten about himself to take care. Okay? Then didn't his doctor tell him to take special precautions against the cold? So doctor has advised him to take precautions, means there is a cool breeze and there is a winter season, he has to be warm. Okay, and even the doctor has also suggested him to keep himself warm, but that thing he has forgotten. Who? This Dattada. But he wouldn't remember to put on a sweater even if it was lying on his bedside chair. So she is asking herself. Okay, so all these words she is telling to herself only, okay, about her husband. So he has forgotten, he wouldn't remember about to wear a sweater. Okay, so which is lying on the bedside. Okay, so at least he could take no. So if he is going out from the room, at least he could wear that sweater which is there on the bedside. Then how could he, when Dibya had put her spell on him? How could he do that when there is a Dibya with him? So he just forgot all those things, even his health also. So that her spell on him, spell means, so this Dibya means this telescope had given some magic. OK, okay. So there is some magic in this Divya according to the Indrani Devi. So because of this Divya, it has so he has forgotten to wear sweater, okay. So this is called spell, means it's a put under the influence. So this Divya, it is a put under influence of its words, that is called a spell, okay. So like that she was said about her husband. So who? Indrani Devi. Then she picked up the white woolen pullover, wrapped herself in a shawl and made her way to the roof. Okay, because they are old people, these two are both couple, means the both husband and wife, they both are old now. So they have to take care and they have to keep themselves warm. Okay, so she is also wear woolen what called wrap on herself, and then she went away, okay, from the room. And then where she has went? She went to the roof to break up his TTRTT with the Divya. TTRTT, it's a private meeting, talk between two persons. So who is talking here? This Divya and also Dattada, they both are having conversation. So now she went, she is thinking that now she is going to the roof to disturb both of them when they are having a conversation. So who is having here? This is Divya and Dattada, but Divya is not a person, it is a telescope, okay. So Dattada, he is watching the sky through the telescope, okay. So he is having some secret ambition. So because of that, he just using this telescope and he called that this is a Divya, okay. Then she found them both huddled together, eye to eye. Huddled means dense and disorderly crowd, okay. So both of them, they are busy in their work, okay. When we are holding telescope, so how we are using? So we just hold it and just look it very observantly from through the eyes. So like that, the both Divya and also Dattada, they both are looking at each other. So she is giving, she personifies here. Then, and he was so thrilled that he called it Divya Jakshus. Okay, at least Dattada was looking into Divya's eyes. So now, so this Dattada, he is watching through the telescope. So this means by the Indrani, so he is looking at the eyes of the Divya. Who is this Dattada? Then she found them both. When Dattada acquired this telescope, he was so thrilled that he called it Divya Chakshu. It means divine eye. Okay. So when Dattada, when he was holding the telescope in his hand, he called it is a Divya Chakshu, which means Chakshu, which means divine eye. So this telescope here, Dattada is telling this Divya, means this telescope, it is a divine eye. That means Divya Chakshu. Then to Indrani Devi, the telescope was like a designing woman who had ensnared her husband. Okay. So this Divya, to Indrani Devi, this telescope is like a woman, a designing woman. Okay. It is like a stylish woman to Indrani Devi. And this, because of this Divya, so Dattada is always just working with this Divya, okay, that is called ensnared her husband. So she just like it Divya and the name stuck. So that's why Indrani Devi, she is calling this telescope, it is a Divya, and the name, it is all of the stuck to her. Okay. So now to Dattada, the telescope marked the fulfillment of the ambition of a lifetime. But so in her view of Indrani Devi, so Divya is one of a thing that she has given a name, that is Divya, and it is like a woman, and she is thinking that always her husband is busy with this Divya. Okay, because, and she used so many words here, but not for Dattada. Okay, so Dattada, so for what, for this Dattada, this telescope is, this telescope was so thrilled that he called, sorry, to Dattada, the telescope marked the fulfillment of the ambition of lifetime. So Dattada, he has ambition in his lifetime. Okay, so he is working for something. He just searching something and he wanted to achieve in his life in regarding some of the work. Okay. So this Divya means this telescope is helping to Dattada. Okay. Then as an amateur astronomer, he had longed for enough money to buy a good telescope and for enough spare time in which to observe the heavens. Actually, this is not a his hobby which he developed in the middle of the age. Actually, he just looking for it from so many years. Okay, as an astronomer, he just wanted to buy a telescope which he could. Okay, and it was too costly, so he couldn't afford it when he was young or when he was in a middle age. But when he was retired, okay, from his work, from his job, at least he got that much of amount. He could bought this telescope, and now he got a lot of time to watch at the sky and to fulfill his ambition. So what is the ambition? Let's see in this further lesson. Okay, and he got them both when he retired with ample money. So he wanted to purchase this telescope. So when he get the chance, when he was retired and he get a good money from his retirement, so from that he had purchased this telescope. And now this telescope was duly installed, and long were the dark nights that Dattada spent in stargazing. Okay, so this telescope, it is helpful for Dattada because of this telescope, because he was looking at the sky and it becomes a regular habit. So whose habit? Dattada's habit. Okay, so through the telescope he just wanted to see at the stars, look at the stars. And then, and at least Indrani Devi thought so. And also Indrani Devi, the wife of Dattada, she is also thinking that he is watching at the sky. He is searching something. When he was watching at the sky, he is searching, and he has had a secret ambition in his life. Okay, so this is, let's move to the next line. Here, put on the sweater, or do you want Nabin Babu to order bed rest tomorrow? So here now Indrani Devi come, and now she asked her husband, put on this sweater. So wear this sweater. So do you, I want to call a Nabin Babu tomorrow for a rest? If you not wear this sweater, so you just ill. So that's why, otherwise I will call a Nabin Babu. So here he is a doctor. If he is advised to you to take a rest, then only you could do. Okay, so that's why he just giving a order to this husband. Okay, that is Dattada, to wear a sweater and protect himself from the cold. Okay, so this is, like every other amateur astronomer, Dattada had a secret ambition that he would one day discover a new comet. So what is the secret ambition here? Now here the writer is just disclosing that what is this ambition, what is the Dattada's ambition in his life. Here the secret ambition is, one day he could discover a new comet. So this is the secret ambition of this Dattada. For comets can be new, coming as they do from the remote corners of the solar system. So this comet, so what he is looking for, he is longing for. So this comet is a new, actually. So when it is coming from the corner of the solar system, so when they were moving in whole space, in our whole space of the solar system, when it is come from the different corner of the solar system, like planets, comets also orbit round the sun, but their orbits are highly eccentric. Here it is explaining about the comets, how this comet is moving towards the sun and also Earth. Okay, so this planet means like planets, how the planets are revolving around the sun, like that this comet is also revolving around the solar system. Okay, and but there is no orbits, its orbits are highly eccentric. So it orbit, it is not equal distance like how we are having the planets of different, that is in the solar system. We have the Venus, Mars and Earth and Jupiter, and then some other, the Saturn and all. So Neptune, they have some orbit. Okay, in that orbit it is revolving around sun. But these comets, it is having a highly eccentric. As a eccentric means unusual and unlike orbits of the of other planets. So their orbits, it is not unusual. Okay, so they can move according to their gravitational force. Okay, their magnetic waves, how it moves, like it is moving. Okay, throughout the solar system. So it is not like a proper orbit of how the planets, it is revolving around the sun like that. So they are also having their orbits, but it is an unusual. Okay, so whose orbit? Comet's orbit. Now, so once in a while a comet comes close to the sun. Okay, so once in a while, so when they were moving around the sun or around to the galaxies and solar system, so once in a while it is coming closer to the sun. Okay, it is not for regularly or then regularly or any unusually. So sometimes, okay, it happens for so many years. It takes a million years, it takes 100 years or 1,000 years, okay, centuries together, it takes time to come closer to the sun, okay. So now, but their orbits, come close to the sun, it has a longish tail that is lit brilliantly by the sunlight, and then it recedes into darkness, not be seen again for years or for centuries, okay. So this comet has its longish tail, okay, its tail is very long. Here I don't have a space to write here the longish tail, so I have written only this much. I have drawn here only this much, so you can imagine how the comet it will be, okay. So it is a longish tail, and sometimes that is very brilliant light, okay. It has a brilliant light, so when the sun lights, when it is coming closer to the sun, so when it is reflected on this comet, so it becomes a brilliant light, okay, a very bright light because of the sunlight. Then it recedes means after, when it is passes towards, means when it is move through the sun, so when it goes back, so again it will be come back to its original, and it was went into the darkness, okay, then not be seen again for years or for century. So when it moves near to the sun, so again it was passed after that light, so it was went on in the darkness, okay, it was goes on into the darkness, and again it will never be seen again, and it takes a 100 years or 1,000 years or centuries together to come again, we can see this comet, okay. So this is the history of this comet. Actually it's a reality, okay. Then what chance did he stand with his eye 8-inch Divya, okay. So this telescope, now here the writer is saying about the telescope, okay, that is the Divya. The size of this telescope, it about a 8-inch, okay, how much size, it's a 8-inch. And then didn't professional astronomers have gigantic telescopes? Even the professional astronomer, because this Dattada is not a professional astronomer, because it is one of his hobby to look into the stars, and he made himself an astronomer. But professional astronomer, he had a huge, means a gigantic telescope. So you know the telescopes, it have a lot of worth to watch at the sky, is it? So when the professional astronomer, they are carrying the gigantic telescopes to look at the stars, okay. Then Dattada was optimistic. This Dattada was hopeful about that. For what? He knew that the professionals with their pre-assigned programs would be looking at faint stars and nebulous galaxies. He knew it. Who? Dattada, he knew that even the professionals means professional astronomer, so they are also looking for, so they are also planning for, pre-assigned programs. So they are programming that would be looking for some of the faint stars, okay, the faint stars and also nebulous galaxies. Okay, they wanted to look some of the stars and galaxies. So the nebulous means hazy galaxies, okay, the hazy galaxies. So they are planning, they are pre-planned to look into the stars. Who? Professional astronomers, but not Dattada. Okay, they might miss such an insignificant thing as a comet, which they were not expecting to see anyway. But according to Dattada, even the professional astronomers, they also missed the chance to watch this comet. But he is very hopeful about himself that he could discover a new comet. Who? Dattada. Actually, by the profession, he is not a professional, okay, but then also he is having a hope that he could find out a new comet. So not, they also miss the chance. Sometimes the professionals also miss the chance, but not me. So I wanted to search a new comet. So this is his thinking, okay, the way of thinking of Dattada, and his ambition too, okay, his ambition, he is hopeful about his work. Then indeed amateurs had often discovered a new comet which the professionals had missed, okay. So it is telling about himself here, this line, it is telling about Dattada. Here he called himself an amateur astronomer, okay, that is a scientist which he could discover a new comet. Sometimes these scientists, like a Dattada, like an amateur scientist, he could discover a new comet, even the professional could not discover it. Okay, so they have that kind of a qualities. Then and it looked to Dattada that tonight was going to be the big night. So when he was eagerly looking for today's night, okay, today means the night where he was sitting at the roof and he was watching at the sky. So this night is going to be a big event for him, okay? So like a big night for him. Why? For against the background of the same old stars, Dattada had detected a faint stranger. So background of the stars, when he was looking at the sky through the telescope, he just find out that some of the faint stranger, something he has find, a strange thing he has find out in the background of the stars, okay? He re-examined, so he find out something, okay, in the space, in the star, in the sky. Then again, he re-examined, he looked something there and he was re-examining himself. The charts with him checked his dibya for any smudges on the optics. So when he is holding telescope, so he just see that he had find out something in the space, okay, that is in the sky. So again he was re-examining himself, he just re-examining his chart, and he was looking at the telescope and he just seeing that is there anything is there in the optics. Optics means the glasses which is used in the telescope, okay. So he was looking there, is it any smudges means it's the spots on the mirror of this lens of this telescope. Lens, you may call it as a lens, okay, lens of this telescope, is there any spots? So like that he was looking, then did some calculation on his pocket calculator in torchlight. So he had some notebook, so he took a notebook from his pocket, he did some calculation from the calculator, from the torch, and again, for though absent-minded about daily course, because this kind of a work, it is not for a one day. Since so many nights he is just looking for this today's night, okay. So daily course means it is a daily habit of this, regular of this Dattada, he is looking for, and whatever he just look into the sky, he is note down it, okay. Then he was meticulous in his observations. Meticulous means he was careful and exact. Now whatever he is just observing, he is just calculating, and he was very careful and he just exact about his work, okay. Then yes, there can be no mistake, what he was looking at had not been there earlier, and it did look like a new comet. Yes, he has discovered it now. So when he was looking at the regular nights, he just did the so many calculations. So but tonight it is very special to him because he had discovered a comet, okay, a new comet. And 2 days later, the Anand Mazar Patrika came out with the news. After 2 days of this discovery, so there is a news came in the newspaper, called, the name of the newspaper is Anand Mazar Patrika. So the news came into the newspaper. What it is, let's see here. Calcutta man discovers new comet, okay. So Calcutta man, because Dattada, he is living in a Kolkata, so there he was discovered a new comet. This is the news from our special correspondent Shri Manoj Datta, a resident on the northern outskirts of Calcutta, has claimed to have discovered a new comet. He has seen the comet on the last two nights and is informed the Indian Institute of Astrophysics at IIA at Bangalore of its whereabouts, okay. So in the newspaper, the article, it has came like this, Shri Manoj Datta. So his name is, his full complete name is Shri Manoj Datta. He is a resident, he is living in a northern outskirts of Kolkata, has claimed to have discovered a new comet. He is claiming that he discovered a new comet. He has seen the comet on the last two nights, okay. So since two nights he just observed the comet and has informed the Indian Institute of Astrophysics. He not only discovered it, when he saw that there is a comet, it is moving in the sky. So he has informed to the Indian Institute of Astrophysics, which is in Bangalore. Okay, that is called IIA. Then the IIA runs a 90-inch telescope. After when he was informed to the Indian Institute of Astrophysics, astrophysics. So then they hold the 90-inch telescope. So he has hold how much inch? Only 8-inch. But those astronomers, they were holding, means they were they kept a 90-inch telescope. Through that telescope, they were also observing in the at the sky, the biggest in Asia at Kavalur. So that 90-inch telescope, it is the biggest in Asia. Okay, where this institute, it which was kept in that work of the astronomer. Okay, if it confirms Dattada's finding, it will be the high point in his lifelong career as amateur astronomer. Okay, so if this calculation which Dattada is telling to the, and he was discovered a new comet, if it is going to be a exact, it is going to be a right, and then he become a it is one of the turning point of the turning point of his career, and he become a amateur astronomer. Okay, Dattada, as he is affectionately called by his friends and admirers, estimates that the comet would be clearly visible to the naked eye in the next few months. So Dattada, he just called to his friends and families and his admirers, and he just saying that the new comet, where it is moving in the solar system, we could also see from the naked eye without telescope, we could also see it. Okay, then for the next few months it is going to be seen. He gives all credit for his discovery to his 8-inch telescope, which he calls Divya. So he give all his credit. Okay, he just giving this kind of a credit to this 8-inch telescope called Divya. Okay, so this is about the story of this lesson. Today I am going to stop here. I will continue in the next class. Okay, I hope that you all are like to listen the story of this comet and Dattada's discovery. Okay, the new discovery. So that is the comet. Okay, so today I am going to stop here. We will meet you in the next class. All of you stay at home, keep learning. Thank you.